Nine times 6ix9ine went too far. Tekashi 6ix9ine is without a doubt the biggest social media troll this world has ever seen. Throughout the years, 6ix9ine has used his social media as a way to bring himself constant attention by being the rainbow-headed rapper with no filter. This tactic has made him many enemies, but also had him as one of the most talked about rappers in the entire industry. He quickly let the attention get to his head, which had him feeling untouchable, and ended up with him pushing things too far on multiple occasions, which not only lost him fans and respect, but also has put him in danger with many different people. In this video, we will show you 8 shocking times Tekashi 6ix9ine went way too far. Make sure to stay until the end, because the top 3 on this list are newly recent situations that will completely shock you. So stay tuned. Also, don't forget to leave a like on this video if you're a fan of 6ix9ine. And if you'd like to join this month's giveaway of a brand new iPhone 11, then all you have to do is subscribe to the channel and watch this video until the end to find and comment the hidden message. Good luck! Number 9. Actions against Chief Keef. 6ix9ine has proven over and over that he would do anything to troll rappers who step into a beef with him, and he has shown how far he's willing to go. In 2018, while he still had a back and forth beef with Chief Keef, 6ix9ine took one of his baby mamas on a shopping spree. He spent $75,000 on her, buying her all sorts of expensive outfits and jewelry. 6ix9ine made sure Chief Keef saw everything after he posted multiple videos of this on his Instagram. This situation is another win for 6ix9ine when it comes to the trolling, but it seems these constant wins must have got to his head, because instead of quitting while ahead, he decided to not let up, which had him pushing it too far, by hiring one of his previous boys to shoot at Chief Keef. This was one of the situations that put him in a bad spot, in court with multiple charges, all to look good for his social media trolling game. Number 8. Comments to Trippie Redd. Trippie and 6ix9ine have been attacking each other for a few years now, with constant back and forth drama. The peak of their beef, and when things went too far, was after 6ix9ine was speaking on all of Trippie Redd's dead friends while they were on IG Live together. This was unnecessary and disrespectful for 6ix9ine to do, in many people's opinions. Bringing deceased friends into the back and forth is very excessive, and it showed how truly disrespectful 6ix9ine is willing to get when it comes to trolling. Unfortunately for Trippie Redd, 6ix9ine still came out with the overall win after he posted a video of him and Trippie Redd's ex-girlfriend, Alex, in bed together. There was some recent controversy to this after an online back and forth happened between 6ix9ine and Alex, where she exposed that it was a video for show and nothing actually happened between them. 6ix9ine had a different side of the story, but either way the truth in that goes, it was never a good look for Trippie Redd. Number 7. Fallout with 50 Cent. The fact that his relationship with 50 Cent will never be on good terms again is both surprising and not surprising. These two artists have had a father-son relationship in the past, but that has officially ended. Both 50 Cent and 6ix9ine are always looking for trouble when it comes to trolling on social media, so it was only a matter of time before they turned on each other. When they were considered friends in the rap game, they would go back and forth in a joking manner. This ended after 50 Cent said he would not work with 6ix9ine or be associated with him after he snitched. That's when 6ix9ine took it too far after he responded and said, "Won't be the first time 50 abandons his son, let me just mind my business." To be honest, that comment was a knockout, but it pretty much solidifies the end of their relationship permanently, which is not a good thing for 6ix9ine, considering he needs friends and cosigns now more than ever. Number 6. Online attacks against Meek Mill. Let's be honest, Meek Mill has made it his sole life purpose to end and discredit 6ix9ine. Like Snoop Dogg, Meek Mill doesn't forgive snitches either. Unlike the case with other artists, 6ix9ine has been gentle with Meek Mill. He hasn't had a lot to say about him. However, when the opportunity presented itself, he dragged Meek Mill through the mud. In an Instagram video, he said Meek Mill is only angry because, despite the fact that he was in jail for 18 months, he's still doing more numbers than him. Now, going against Meek Mill isn't the problem, but the timing is where 6ix9ine went too far by risking too much. During his home lockup, 6ix9ine was going after Meek Mill harder than ever via Instagram Live while his entire online activity was being monitored. This was a risky move by 6ix9ine, which could have had him locked back up. Luckily for him, he got away with his extreme trolling, but it makes it very clear that 6ix9ine has no intention of moving in a smarter direction, and he shows no signs of knowing when to take a step back to not push things too far. Number 5. Online attacks against Snoop Dogg. In addition to the Meek Mill situation, the problem wasn't trolling Snoop Dogg, the problem was the timing. During the time 6ix9ine was attacking Meek Mill while on house arrest, he was also attacking Snoop Dogg at the same time, which made his trolling much less under control as far as restrictions. After making multiple videos accusing Snoop Dogg of snitching and making multiple comments via Instagram Live, 6ix9ine was risking it all with the extreme amounts of trolling during a time where being low-key should have been his number one priority. Somehow though, as we have all witnessed, 6ix9ine just dodges bullet after bullet. After still being set free despite the constant online trolling attacks of so many rappers, it's safe to say that 6ix9ine has lucked out once again. Number 4. Accusations against Ariana Grande and Justin Bieber. Now, before we get into our final and most shocking, this situation is less critical as most on this list, but it's a situation worth mentioning. 6ix9ine had no public relationship with Ariana Grande and Justin Bieber before he was locked up, but there's no chance of him having any collaboration or friendship with these two stars in any future, after he publicly accused them of buying their way to the number one spot on the Billboard charts. 6ix9ine called out Ariana Grande, Justin Bieber, and Billboard, and accused them of conniving to rig the chart. He said Grande and Bieber used 6 different credit cards to buy their way to the top. Even though all the parties involved have denied any foul play, it takes some nerve to embarrass two top artists like that, and then drag Billboard into it. This just invites their entire fanbase to dislike 6ix9ine, which is the last thing he needs, considering how disliked he already is by so many. Number 3. The decision that will follow him forever. No matter how far 6ix9ine has taken his online beef with other rappers, nothing compares to the decision he made to snitch in court. This will be a decision that 6ix9ine will have to live with and hide from forever. The amount of enemies he has made from his social media trolling does not even come close to the enemies he made after snitching. This was the decision that has saved 6ix9ine from living his life in prison, but it's also the decision that could end up taking his life at any given moment. Snitching is a dangerous play, especially when it involves gangs and street life. This has made 6ix9ine a target, and with thousands of threats already made against him, the danger is very real, and this tough decision could be catching up with him at any given moment. Number 2. Ego-influenced decisions. 6ix9ine has pretty much felt untouchable his entire career, and for a while he had many of us convinced that he actually was. He did get away with a lot more than expected, so we can see why he felt this way. But after his arrest, this mindset of being invincible should have vanished from 6ix9ine's mind. If he was smart, he would probably be on a low-key vibe, just focusing on the music. But surprise, surprise, moving smart seems to have never even crossed his mind. Since being free to move around, 6ix9ine has decided to play the untouchable gangster once again, by walking all over the streets of New York. While he's taken precaution with his new security team, this is still one of the dumbest things 6ix9ine has ever done. The danger against him is more real than he seems to comprehend, and he is pressing his luck day after day. To make things worse, he jumps on social media and brags about being able to walk around, despite being threatened by so many. He seems to be showing no fear and no signs of taking a step back to move in a smarter direction. Number 1. Taking disrespect to a new level. Now, just when you think 6ix9ine couldn't possibly push his luck any further, he decided to make one of his worst decisions yet, after he recently showed a video of him at Nipsey Hussle's mural. 6ix9ine made it out to seem as a way of saying RIP and showing respect, but others are taking it very offensively, and for obvious reasons. It's clear 6ix9ine is using it as a way to show him moving around, and as a way to gain more attention, which makes it disrespectful either way you look at it. Clearly 6ix9ine has taken many situations too far, but none as far as he has taken this one. And with that, we end today's list. What do you think about the recent actions of 6ix9ine? Do you think he's taken any other situation way too far that deserves a spot on this list? Let us know your thoughts down in the comments below. Also, don't forget to leave a like on this video, and subscribe to the channel if you're new. Thanks for watching, we'll see you in the next one!